Hey guys, so today we're checking out the Raxxium LED taillights fitting all 2018 and newer JL Wranglers with the factory halogen taillights. Now, if you've busted up a taillight while you were out on the trail or even on the street and you're looking for an overall upgrade, or you're just not happy with the lighting performance from your factory halogen taillights and you're looking for an upgrade there, these are going to be a great option to take a look into. Now, what I really like about these taillights is that these are very similar to the factory style LED package taillights, giving a more modernized feel to the Wrangler. Now, these are going to look very similar, but what I like about them is the fact that they're not going to come with that Mopar OEM price point. Now, these are going to have multiple LEDs inside of the taillight itself, creating a very bright light in comparison to that halogen bulb. Now, that's going to be great if you're looking for some better lighting performance out of the back end of your JL for safety reasons, making you more noticeable on the road to other drivers. And again, it's going to look more modernized and a lot more stylish with that LED. With these, you're also getting that black trim on the outside on the housing. You're getting that reflector on the side that comes with the LED and halogen factory taillights, but you're getting a lot of upgrades in the meantime. You are switching the location for that backup light, as well as adding an LED for a lot of visibility when backing up at night, and you're getting a fiber optic running light that goes all the way around the taillight and a little up at the top and the bottom. Again, that's going to add some dynamic styling to the back end of your Wrangler, and it's going to be a big upgrade from the factory halogen housing. Now, that being said, these are going to come in at roughly $350, and in my personal opinion, I think that that's set at a very fair price point for what you're getting out of this kit. Now, you're getting a very bright LED. You're also getting some LED styling from the factory, which in my opinion is going to look very clean on the back of this sport here. And again, you're not paying that OEM price point. Not to mention, in the kit, you're also getting resistors for the halogen to the LED switch for no weird characteristics of the light itself. And it's going to be completely plug and play with everything that you need in the kit. Now, I personally really like that. You don't have to swap anything over, unlike some other options. And that's going to keep it very simple and a no fuss install. Now, choosing taillights does come down a lot of the time to styling. Some may be set up a little bit differently. Some may include a different pattern to the LEDs themselves, or they may just include different lenses, like a Euro style clear lens or even a smoke lens for a more stealthy look. Now, again, in my opinion, I think if you're just looking for an upgrade to the lighting performance, as well as the look and a more modernized look, and even some OEM styling to this, these are going to be a great choice to take a look into. So again, install is going to be very easy. I'm going to give it a 1 out of 3 wrenches on the difficulty meter. You're going to need some very basic hand tools for this. So speaking of that install, let me run you through that right now. Tools that I used for this install were a trim removal tool, the ratchet, and the T40 Torx from the JL toolkit. So our first step to this install is to start in our cargo area. We're going to have a small trim piece on the back of our cargo area trim here. It is directly behind our taillight. I'm going to take a trim removal tool and pop that off. There is a little divot here that will allow you to do that. You could also use a flathead screwdriver if you'd want, but just be careful because you don't want to mess up the trim. Now on the inside, you're going to have a plastic spring-loaded screw. I'm actually going to use the JL toolkit that's included in every JL. I'm going to take the ratchet out, as well as the T40 Torx, and we can use that to remove the screw that's holding in our taillight. So what we can do now is just give our taillight a good tug and it'll pull right out. Then we can disconnect this harness here. Just gonna pull up on this safety release. Press down on that tab and pull back. Maybe a little bit difficult at first. All right. So first thing we're gonna do with our new taillight is actually mount up our resistor. There is gonna be some 3M tape on the back, but you're also going to have some mounting locations if you would like to mount it up inside your taillight area. I'm just going to peel this 3M back, and we can stick it on the inside of this well here.
Just give it a good press.
I'd also recommend that this area or wherever you're sticking the resistor is clean. Then after that is on there, what we can do is plug in our wiring harness. This is going to be completely plug and play and a factory style harness on our taillight. Once you hear a click, set the red locking tab, and then we can mount up our taillight just like we did with our factory one. There's gonna be little tabs that you wanna line up. Give it a good press. Then we can head back inside our cargo area and secure it down with the factory hardware. What we can do is thread in our screw. Now it is plastic. You wanna make sure that you don't over tighten it. The spring in here will make sure that it stays in place. So again, don't over tighten this because it may break since it is plastic. But we're just going to thread that into the factory location, and that'll thread into the back of our taillight. I also have a hand on the taillight as well. Once that is threaded in, we can take our ratchet, start to tighten that up. So once that bolt is tightened down, what we can do is just reinstall this trim piece and repeat that same process on the other side. Before we install our new taillight setup, I did want to stop down and tell you guys a little bit more about it, some of the benefits and characteristics in comparison to our factory halogen taillights. Now, as a brief overview, what you're getting with this halogen setup is obviously that halogen bulb. You're getting some very simplistic OEM styling. You're going to have that red lens, the reflector around the body or the whole taillight itself around the housing. Then you're gonna have that backup lens down at the bottom with the halogen backup light. Now, this is overall gonna be a great setup for OEM applications, but they are not going to be as bright as an LED, and again, the styling is very simplistic. Now, when we move over to this new taillight setup, that is not going to be the case. This is gonna come with those very bright LEDs, giving you better visibility out of the rear end of your Wrangler, while also making you a lot more noticeable while you're driving around on the street or even on the trail. Now, what I really like about this setup is that this is going to almost be a carbon copy of the LED factory taillights on the LED package JLs. Now this is going to have some OEM styling as far as the LED package is concerned, but it's gonna look a lot more modernized and have some dynamic styling in comparison to our factory halogen setup. Now again, those LEDs are going to be incredibly bright, and what I really like about this is that it's a completely plug and play setup and you are getting resistors. So when you're moving over from a halogen to an LED with this resistor, you're not gonna get any weird characteristics like hyper flashing or any weird characteristics with the LED light in general. Now overall, I do really like the setup and the style of these taillights. Again, they are gonna look a lot more modernized in comparison to our halogen setup here. You're getting the red lens, you're relocating that backup light into the middle, again, for styling purposes, and you're also getting a very similar housing in comparison to the OEM style halogen setup and even the LED setup. So you're getting the trim on top that is almost that textured material, but it is going to give a very OEM feel, even though it is an upgrade. So I do really like how these are set up, and they are going to perform a lot better than our factory halogens as far as lighting performance goes. So what do you say we go ahead and install our other taillight? that's going to wrap it up for my review and install. Make sure you like and subscribe. And for more videos and products like this, always keep it right here at ExtremeTerrain.com.